Albert, is this the glade with the stone statues?
That's correct, Regina. And this is Ray, a friend of that girl I was telling you about.
There are so many statues here. Do you really think that they can be revived?
Oh, now I believe that. Yes, it is possible. Do you remember my telling you about my mentor, Teacher Young?
Yes, I heard so many amazing things about him from you.
That's right. He carried out experiments with the petrified and made significant discoveries. For example, more than once he managed to restore a piece of stone clothing to its original state. What happened next was a disaster. Teacher Young tried to revive a man, and what's most striking, he succeeded, but unfortunately, only for a fraction of a second. Just after the revival, the unfortunate soul greedily gasped for air, looked around, and dropped dead.
Resurrected and died again? That poor man. Who was he?
Well, he was the closest relative of the head advisor. Can you imagine? That is why, immediately after this, Teacher Young was banished into the depths of the forest. And he was prohibited from engaging in any scientific experiments and researches.
But what makes you think now that a resurrection is possible?
Well, I found the information at the Gorgon's temple, which formerly my teacher was not aware of. But before we begin executing our plan, I'd rather go see him and double-check a few things.
May I go with you?
Oh, no, that won't be necessary. I'd be grateful if instead you prepared the lab. It's all cluttered up and we'll need a lot of space to place the stone statues. Teacher Young lives in the forest ever since that misfortune. I haven't visited him in a while. This is the airship that Alice and her friends arrived on. It's interesting how everything is arranged here. Finally, I'm almost there. I completely forgot that the teacher's house is directly on the marsh. But somehow, the old man manages just fine here.
Gilbert, I haven't seen you in ages.
Hi, teacher. How is your health?
Still kicking. If only my ears would stop letting me down.
I think you are not aware of the latest events. Well, three strangers showed up right on the glade of the petrified bodies. As expected, two of them became imprisoned right away, turning, like many others before them, into stone. But the third, a young girl, not only came to our settlement, but somehow freed the spirit of the Gorgon from the mirrored imprisonment.
How is this possible? Are you sure, Albert? The Gorgon spirit is free.
Fortunately, that's no longer the case. We managed to trap the Gorgon in a snare similar to the previous one, but hopefully more secure this time. While we were planning to execute our trap, I have found a few very interesting records in the temple. And now, teacher, I think I know a surefire way to revive Petrified.
Albert, I doubt you want to follow my bad experience and the consequences that followed.
You know, I'm almost certain that this time everything will work out. The only thing I'm missing is the formula of the liquid which you used back then.
The necessary documents are in my chest, but it is tightly sealed, and I'm afraid I do not know what happened to the locket that opens it. It seems that the locket, as well as some of my other things, was dragged out by that nasty bird coming to my house when I'm out for berries and mushrooms.
I'll go look around for it. Maybe I'll be lucky enough to find it.
Thank you.
That was fast, Albert. I'll go get my notes now.
Thank you, teacher. But I am concerned about one more thing. Back then, how did you move the statue? Knowing a sound method to revive the petrified people and then accidentally damage them during transportation. Oh, I'd like to avoid that.
Oh, that. It was the bird lady who helped me back then. Ophelia. Remember her? I think, at this time, she might be close. Go check the dungeon. The one that's under the dried-up hollow tree. And do you remember that right from there you can take a shortcut straight into the heart of the settlement? Just climb to the top of that same tree.
Thank you. I hope everything will work out.
Well, good luck, Albert. Don't forget to let me know how everything goes.
Not aware of this shortcut. It turns out that it leads directly to my house.
So, Albert, have you succeeded?
Yes, Regina. I see the whole picture now. Teacher Young used a special liquid trying to turn the statue into its original state.
He shared the chemical formula of the liquid with you? And we will use it?
Well, yes and no. His main mistake was that instead of the liquid form of the substance, he should have used its gaseous state.
That's the only adjustment and everything will work? Are you sure?
I'm 99% certain. We'll need a large glass vessel in which we'll put the stone statues. Will you get it ready? And meanwhile, I'll try to figure out a way to very carefully transport Alice's friends to the laboratory. And please find methanol at its maximum concentration. Hello, Ophelia.
Oh, Albert, I did not expect to see you. What brings you here?
Well, will you lend me one of your special birds? My task is to move a large, and most importantly, a fragile and valuable cargo.
Of course. Take one of them to help you. Only, do you still remember how to direct them?
Oh, your lessons are hard to forget. On the other hand, quite a few years have passed since.
Right, but I'd better remind you. Above all, do not forget to give water to the bird, with some red pepper powder added. That's how you earn its trust and loyalty. I've prepared everything, and here's the liquid you asked for. Excellent, Albert. Look, they've already come to their senses.
Who are you? And Alice, where is she?
She's gone. Young and fearless girl. I really hope that you will meet again.